Hello everyone and welcome back. This is Doc Ed Padama. Ngayon pag-usapan natin ang Chapter 5, Summary Findings, Conclusions and Recommendations. Kaya lang hahatiin natin ito sa tatlong bahagi. So ito yung unang bahagi kung paano isulat yung Chapter 5 at pag-usapan natin kung paano isulat yung Summary of Findings. So ano yung format na sinusunod dito sa Summary of Findings, kasi meron tayong kailangan balikan doon sa chapter 1 na kailangan nating isama dito sa summary of findings. And then, ano yung susunod na bahagi na kailangan nating isulat o sagutin doon sa bahagi na unang isinulat natin. Makikita nyo mamaya ito sa sample na gagamitin natin. So, una, punta tayo doon sa unang tip and advice. The summary of findings should directly answer the statement of the problem. Ito yung sinasabi natin kanina, na kailangan kunin ninyo mula sa chapter 1 ninyo kung ano yung eksaktong nakasulat sa statement of the problem 1 ninyo. Specific problem number 1. I-restate nyo lang ito, ibig sabihin isulat nyo lang ito, and then immediately below SOP 1 or specific problem 1, isulat ninyo kung ano yung sagot or yung tinatawag na nating findings doon sa specific problem na yon. Doon ngayon papasok yung tinatawag nating summary of findings. Ganun yung ipipresent. So, puntahan na natin sandali yung example natin. Dito, sa summary of findings, makikita ninyo meron tayong introductory statement. So, ito yung tinatawag nating introductory statement. And then, immediately after that, ito na yung summary of findings na part. So, ito yung sinasabi nating statement of the problem, restating the specific problem. This is specific problem number one. So, yun yung unang tip natin. Okay? The summary of findings should directly answer the statement of the problem. And then, pagkatapos nyo state yung SOP number one, mapapansin nyo, doon sa unang bahagi, itong nasa ibaba niya, this is already the finding based on chapter 4 ng inyong research, which is the presentation, analysis, interpretation of data. So makikita niyo may mga values dito na ginamit galing doon sa table from the previous chapter. Okay? So tingnan natin yung tip number 2. Do not include discussions or findings that are not reflected in your statement of the problem. So ang magiging guide niyo dito para hindi kayo magkaroon ng misdirection doon sa goal ng research ninyo, ang guide ninyo will be the specific problems. Kung ano lang yung question sa SOP ninyo, sa statement of the problem ninyo, yun lang ang dapat yung direktang sasagutin dito sa part ng research ninyo, ng summary of findings. Okay? Kaya, base your answers directly from the findings of chapter 4, and then ulitin natin, make sure that you restate the specific problem para ito yung maging guide ninyo. Next, tip number 3. The presentation of the findings should be objective and based on the analyzed data based from the previous chapter of your study. So, ito yung inuulit-ulit natin kanina. Get your findings, your data, your values from the previous chapter. Next, tip number 4. Walang conclusion, walang recommendation na dapat isama dito sa part ng study ninyo. Kaya kung mapapansin ninyo, doon sa pangalawang part, nandun yung conclusion and then recommendation. So, hiwalay natin pag-uusapan ito. So, ulitin natin, in-establish lang natin dito sa pag-uusap natin at nire-remind at ine-emphasize na yung findings ninyo should directly answer your specific problem, and yung sagot ninyo should be directly taken from the previous chapter. So, I hope you were able to get that. Okay? Next, number 5. The format of this part of the study may be presented by starting with an introductory statement. So again, nakita nyo kanina yung sample ng introductory statement natin at alam nyo na kung ano yung concept pag sinabi nating introductory statement. It just presents or states the content of this particular part of your research. Sinasabi niya lang doon sa introductory statement kung ano yung i-expect nyo makita, mabasa dito sa part ng research na ginagawa ninyo. Next, tip number 6. This would then be followed by the presentation of the first specific problem, then immediately in the new paragraph, the presentation of the finding corresponding to this problem. So again, nire-reiterate niya lang, inuulit niya lang, na pagkatapos niyong state yung SOP, present niyo na yung finding ninyo. Actually, you're just putting this together. Okay? The SOP or the specific problem comes from chapter 1. Ilagay niyo lang ulit dito sa chapter 5. And then, yung findings ninyo will come from the analysis that was computed doon sa previous chapter, which is chapter 4. Okay, next, number 7. Repeat this form with the preceding specific problems of the study. So if you have more than once, obviously, if you have more than one specific problems, ganito din yung process na gagamitin ninyo. As you observe, you may use values, numeric values, based from the analysis ng chapter 4. But in the next part, especially sa conclusion, wala na kayong dapat ilalagay na values dito sa part ng conclusion ninyo. So, in the summary of findings, this is SOP 1. This is SOP 1. But you don't need to write SOP 1 anymore. So, nirestate niya lang yung SOP 1, which is this one. And then after that, this is based from the findings of chapter 4. Okay? So, you just summarize this and present the data, the numeric values, and the meaning of these values based from the SOP or the statement of the problem that you are discussing. Okay, and then sabi nga natin dun sa last tip, you follow and use this on the preceding statement of the problems or specific problems. So again, this is SOP number 2. And then under SOP number 2, you have 2.1, 2.2. So this is the question for 2.1, and this is the answer for 2.1. Again, this was taken from the previous chapter. Yung mga values na makikita nyo dyan were all taken from the previous chapter. So, as you go on, you do the same procedure until you reach the last specific problem that you used in your research paper. So, in this case, meron siyang ginamit na 7 specific problems. So, as you can see, again, please observe how the findings were presented using the numeric values and numeric data, and then also observe the format. Okay? So, this is important when you are writing your research paper. So, here, you have chapter 5, title of chapter 5, the introductory statement, and then the first part of chapter 5, which is the summary of findings, and then you have the SOP, a written in bold, that's the format that I was talking about, and then below that, immediately below the statement of the problem, you have the findings based on the previous chapter, which is the presentation, analysis, and interpretation of data. Okay, so this is how the first part of chapter 5 should look like, which is the summary of findings. So this again will depend on the number of statement of the problem or specific problems that you have in your research. I hope you were able to get something from our discussion today. And again, I'm going to ask for your help to please subscribe to my YouTube channel, at Talk at Padama. You're going to see my icon on the lower right side of your screen. You just click that, and then recommended videos will appear on the left side of your screen na makakatulong sa inyo sa pagsusulat nyo ng iba't ibang bahagi ng research ninyo. Meron po tayo mga Tagalog or Taglish versions dyan that would easily help you in writing your research paper. So aside from that, you would also see videos that would help you in preparing for your defense, whether it's a research proposal or a final oral defense. Maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat. Again, stay safe and God bless everyone. See you on the next video. Bye!